Today we have our senior technical sales lead for Royal Cyber. Her name is Antoline Natasha, and she would be leading the webinar today. If you guys have, since we all have interactive webinars, if you guys have any questions, any queries, you can kindly email your queries at commerce.marketing@royalcyber.com, and we will get back to you with the answers for them. Without any further ado, let me introduce our speaker for today, our Senior Technical Sales Lead for Royal Cyber, Ms. Antoline Natasha.
Hi all. Good morning and welcome to Royal Cyber's webinar on IBM WebSphere Commerce Feature Pack 8. Thanks Amar for the brief introduction on today's webinar. And as he has already introduced, I'm working with Royal Cyber as the Senior Technical Sales Lead for B2B and B2C e-commerce platforms, and I come with an overall experience of 11 and a half years. So without much delay, let's move into to see the agenda for today's webinar. So on the screen is displayed the agenda for this 45 minutes session that we plan to do. We will begin with to see what's new in the Feature Pack 8 release of IBM WebSphere Commerce. We will also start to see what major enhancements are there in this space. The biggest enhancement is the Aurora B2B Starter Store features. So we would be covering a bit of it in those sections. We would focus on the power of buyer organizations soon after we see the Aurora B2B Starter Store features. So we would be discussing the buyer admin privileges, buyer's privileges, and so on. Next, we would move on and look at contracts for the benefit of people who need a briefing on B2B commerce. So under contracts, we would be covering pricing and catalogs associated with contracts. Next on our agenda would be the enhancements in Management Center specific to Feature Pack 8. We would also see the REST API framework enhancements following the Management Center enhancements. There is a section for us to cover on the update in Feature Pack 8 with respect to utilities such as data load, data extract utilities. We would see search enhancements soon after that. And we would be concluding with the enhanced integration capabilities that this latest feature pack offers in the space of Sterling CPQ and also IBM Tea Leaf. I'm moving on to see the content of the webinar today. So before we move into technical details or before we start to discuss the core topics of this webinar, let's ponder over these questions that is currently there on the screen for us. So what if your digital presence or your business could do all of these, like deliver an engaging B2C experience like a feature in a B2B world, or if your business or the digital presence can enable buyers to interact anywhere, anytime through any kind of device, or if the business can execute strategies for every customer interaction that can be done on your storefront, if your digital storefront can accelerate the onboarding of new buyers associated to your organization, and how it can efficiently manage or configure products and services, whether it can confidently commit to delivery dates, whether it can provide an integrated pre-sales or post-sales process, and whether it has the capability to provide governance or whether it can have control of codes and approvals here. So WCS Feature Pack 8 has answers to most of these, or I should say all of these questions, in a single out-of-the-box platform, and let's see how it is fulfilled. So a B2B organization can now deliver the same rich content, similar cutting-edge capabilities, and also productivity benefits that one experiences using a B2C site. And also, when you're talking about enabling buyers to interact anywhere and anytime, think about what the businesses that are launching their websites on smart devices so that a buyer, a customer can kind of access this from their smart devices. So that capability is also provided with this new feature pack release. Precision marketing activities or promotional events for every customer interaction, that is possible with WebSphere Commerce Feature Pack 8. And also the product recommendations, merchandising associations like cross-sell, upsell activities are all parts of business strategies that we can adopt with every customer interaction. So accelerating the onboarding of new buyers, yes, we have a solution now with all the process that can happen on the storefront rather than seeking out to the use of org admin console or any other commerce tools here. Managing configurable products and services, enhanced integration to IBM Sterling Configurator. We can manage all the predefined configurations of the products that we have in WebSphere Commerce, including price locking for a specific set of customers. Integration to order management solution or use of fulfillment centers. So can kind of answer the commitment to the delivery dates that WebSphere Commerce supports. The pre-sales support comes in with checking the product's availability across all of its fulfillment centers so that we can remove any unwanted out-of-stock notification, and it also results in increased revenues. Post-sales is about warranty support or managing the refunds where we have cases of order cancellation and return of products. So in terms of providing governance or control over quotes and approval, we have the administrative roles in the storefront to aid this, like a buyer administrator. So just in case you have orders or quotes which exceed a certain value of dollars or currency, it would be brought under the approval process and the intervention of an administrator. As I said, a buyer administrator can be configured to be made mandatory. And for this, we have the commerce tools to aid us in this process. Moving on to see what WCS 7 Feature Pack 8 can help us to lead the e-commerce race. So what factors do you really think that can expedite online sales in this world of e-commerce? So on the screen, we see three crucial factors, the top one listed being customer experience, which also determines customer loyalty. So basically, the ease of use of a storefront with very enriched customer experience is certainly a parameter, I'm sure all of you would agree with me, to boost customer loyalty. So your customers are really going to keep returning to your site if their shopping experience on your site is exemplary, and thereby your conversions online are certainly going to be better. So there is an increasing demand of this with the B2B customers as well over a past time. So what they were demanding is a B2C kind of experience, and the Aurora B2B store, which comes in this Feature Pack 8 release, has made this possible. When we say an ease of use of a storefront, site search certainly plays an increasing role here. So when we search for a product, so the advanced search with higher relevancy figures, WebSphere Commerce has the solution to enable this and make site search with much better improvements, and that certainly enhances customer experience also. On this slide, we see the list of major enhancements that Feature Pack A8 has. So we've been talking a lot on the Aurora B2B Starter Store. So it's a single starter store. We would be covering a lot of features in the upcoming slides as well. So it is a store archive, a single store archive, which during the time of publishing can determine whether you want it for your B2B need or your B2C need. Your B2B store is also available with responsive web design like your B2C, so that device portability is possible. We have new enhancements in the promotions and marketing activities of commerce. WebSphere Commerce search enhancements are now available with rule-based sales categories, and there is improved faceted navigation of products also. As I said, with IBM Sterling CPQ for product configuration needs, and also there is enhanced integration with IBM Tea Leaf and the IBM Digital Analytics through a digital data exchange. We will see how it is achieved when we deal with these sections. So on the Aurora starter stores, the B2B and the B2C starter stores, what they are pre-built, fully functional starter stores with all these features that we see on the screen. When we talk about buyer-centric marketing, it's more on precision marketing. So it gives the buyer or the customer who visits your storefront a personalized experience. There are a set of dialogue activities, e-marketing spots that you can configure specific to the customer who is visiting the storefront on successful login. Contract-based prices or contract-based catalogs are B2B features. So specific organizations or buyers belonging to these organizations, when they log into your storefront, can see the associated product information for which they are entitled to. So that is achieved through a concept called catalog filter. We would also see how what it is. And the pricing for these customers can also vary according to their login. Cross-sell, upsell, merchandising associations that can be configured on the storefront to improve your online conversions. Promotions, again, another feature of having discounts, coupons, so that you win customer loyalty and you improve online conversions. Order approval workflow of B2B, we were talking about the governance of quote or approval. So here a buyer administrator is brought in so that his intervention is needed for approving orders or quotes which exceed a specific value. Product fast finder or landing pages. So the storefront uses multifaceted filters for us to narrow down on the products, and we can configure search term associations so that we can find the relevant pages associated to the product that you're searching for. There is support for recurring orders. So this is a feature so that a user can place repeated orders for a specific period of time. It uses the scheduling utility in WebSphere Commerce. In the space of multifaceted navigation, we discussed it. So use of facets to filter or narrow down on search results is possible. Search engine optimization, it is well-known technique, so that search engines can point to your correct pages on your site. It can be product pages, your marketing pages, or even static pages, which is very specific to your business. In multilingual, multi-currency support, WebSphere Commerce supports 13 languages and more than 60 plus currency types. So it gives WebSphere Commerce the ability to support multiple geographies, and also it facilitates globalization. In user account management, all user profiles are maintained within WCS. It keeps track of the user's personal information, other attributes such as his wish list, requisition list, saved orders, and also history of all his other orders. An end-to-end checkout process that basically begins with adding the desired item to the cart till it is fulfilled if it is possible within WebSphere Commerce. Support for product attributes and assets is available, so you can add supporting information to your product information. It could either be rich media like an MP3 file or a video file to describe your product's capabilities. It could be PDF documents, like your technical manuals or specifications that can more describe your product in detail. Enhanced operational automation comes into place where you're talking about integration to order management systems like Sterling OMS, so that the complete order management and even to a fulfillment solution is possible. Widget-based social integration, it is now can be plugged and enabled in the storefront, the social commerce feature. Last but not the least, the responsive web design of the starter store that gives Aurora starter store the device portability to be accessed upon various devices like your smartphones, tablets and your desktops. So we see the screen of the IBM starter store right in front of us. The snapshots are specific to B2B starter store of Aurora. So you can see the e-marketing spots, which gives the ability to configure precision marketing activities so that on successful login of a user, he would see the marketing or promotional event that is very specific to his organization or to his login. Even the product recommendations or discounts that is offered to him can be configured in the home page. Here is a product listing page. You see the multifacet navigation that we discussed about in the left. We would discuss about the image facets that is now available on the Aurora B2B in a later slide. This is a SKU listing page, of which again we would talk about. Requisition list is yet another feature for repeat ordering of certain items. So again, I would be covering this in a later section. So with a fully functional starter store, the time taken for a customer or a business to be launched in the market is now reduced. So that's we say the accelerate time to market with a starter store. And obviously, the look and feel of this starter store is now giving you a B2C kind of experience for a B2B customer. We would talk about the buyer admin features now. So the feature pack 8 release of WebSphere Commerce gives the flexibility for buyer admins to manage all of the listed features through the storefront. So the self-service organization management. So if this feature offers buyer admins to self-service all his organization needs, so without going into an organization admin console. So he would be doing all the organization activities through the storefront itself. So activities that are included here are basically like creating buyers within the organization. So he can add new buyers for his organization, and he would search through the available set of roles within his organization and assign such roles to the buyers. He would be brought as an intervening authority in case of order approval or buyer approval. And also a unique feature that is now available in Feature Pack 8 release is a buyer admin can now buy on behalf of other buyers. Assume a scenario where a buyer has added items to his cart and would need approval or would want the buyer admin to kind of proceed with the checkout in his absence. This can be now done by a buyer admin who logs in into his account. So on successful login, he sees a feature to buy on behalf of. He types the buyer's name, selects the organization or the contract that he is bound to, and continues shopping. So through this feature, the buyer admin would now see the shopping cart of the buyer, and he would proceed to do the checkout for the buyer. The other options that a buyer admin can see are in his My Account page, where he sees requisition lists pertaining to his order. There are orders that needs to be approved by him. There are also buyers that he needs to approve. So buyers who register through the storefront. So those approvals are sought after through the buyer admin, and these options are available to the buyer admin. This is a screenshot that shows that what roles a buyer admin can assign to fellow buyers in his organization. He can also enable user account or disable user account of certain buyers in his organization. A detailed view of the pages. So again, the My Account page with all the features that I have talked about. So he sees the buyer details, his contact information, so that the buyer admin can do much better organizational control and can also accelerate the complete onboarding process of his organization rather than waiting for individual buyers to do the sign up by themselves. A buyer admin can do it on their behalf. Again, approvals with regards to buyers and orders and assigning roles. So after looking at buyer admin specific features, we will now see what buyer features are. So a buyer basically has the feature to select the contract soon after his successful login. So the screen that you see on the right has this depicted. So soon after a buyer logs in, he gets a drop down to select the organization he belongs to and all the contracts that he is entitled to. So he can select the organization and contract and continue to browse through the site to do his checkout and shopping. The other specific features that a buyer has is the CSV upload utility for requisition list. So a brief overview that I wish to give on requisition list is it is a list of items that can be ordered at a later point in time. And it is also used for repeat ordering. So the buyer now has the feature to upload all requisition lists through a CSV upload. So the snapshot of that from the storefront is placed for your view here. And from the Commerce Composer specific utilities, a buyer can now use B2B specific widgets. We will see what widgets they are when we deal with the Commerce Composer section. So that those widgets basically enable better catalog browsing for the buyer to manage the catalog and also to proceed with shopping and checkout. Okay, so I'll go over the contracts in B2B commerce for the benefit of people who needs an overview of contracts in the business-to-business model scenario. So contracts as listed here, they define the terms and conditions for a customer to purchase the products from a store. So a customer who logs in into the storefront may need a purchase access or visibility to only specific set of products or categories on the storefront. So for this, we enable a phenomenon called as the catalog filter using the management center. I will brief you on what catalogs filters are and how it is configured in the management center in the subsequent slide. So by enabling catalog filters for buyers, we define what catalog or what products this buyer can see on the storefront. So, so that he will only choose from what is applicable for his purchase. As part of the catalog filter, we have the next set of terms. The price lists. So price lists are basically a part of catalog master data where it documents all the offer and list prices for the products. But in case a buyer needs to have a discounted price on a specific product or a case where a customer's need to have a product associated with certain charges based on his geography, this can be associated by using price rules for this customer. So the price rule will make use of price equations and price constants so that when the customer is visiting the storefront, he will see the price according to his contract. So as I talked about, he will either see the discounted price that is applicable for him, or if additional charges are calculated for those products, he will see the products. These are dynamically calculated when the customer visits that specific page alone. Price load data load utility is also available for uploading all the price list information to the storefront. Contracts can be exported or imported into WCS if contracts have been externally managed in some other system apart from WCS. So the information that is imported and exported is generally in the form of XML files. So catalog filters, we talked on it when we discussed contracts. So here is a view of how it is done using the management center's catalog filter and pricing rule. So a master catalog with all the top categories are basically chosen in the catalog filter and pricing tool, and those that is specific to the customer, whether it needs to be included or excluded, it is done so by right clicking on the specific catalog top category, and the change is made as shown here. So that when the customer who has this catalog filter associated will log in, and based on the contract that he is bound to, will see those specific products alone on the storefront. So as already said, we can also upload catalog filter information that is received from external system into the tool. That is also possible within WebSphere Commerce. Price rules. So price rules as detailed, it is basically a set of instruction that is used to generate prices on the storefront dynamically. So here is a view of how price rules are configured using the management center. So the path for dynamically calculating a price rule is dealt here. So there is a condition that decides whether a customer who belongs to a specific organization and also is accessing a specific category of products. Here we are seeing coffee tables, will go through this price list condition and will see a price associated to him. In all other cases, the price list that is part of the default catalog is fetched. So these, I repeat, are only dynamically calculated on the storefront, and it is not permanently set for any customer at the back end. Requisition list, it is again a B2B feature. So it carries a list of all items that one wishes to order at a later date. So it can basically carry information that is specific to the product, like the attributes associated to the product of inside the catalog, namely the SKU, we have the quantity, the last updated time of the product or SKU, the owner, and also the store to which it belongs to. There are two types of requisition list, the private or the shared requisition list. Basically, the private requisition list can be accessed or modified only by the creator. For all shared requisition lists, the users or buyers within the organization can have access to this requisition list, and they can also submit the order using a shared requisition list. As seen in the buyer features section, we have the CSV upload for requisition lists in the Aurora B2B storefront in this feature pack 8 release. We will move on to see management center specific enhancements in feature pack 8. So on the screen you see four different sections of enhancements. One is the role of a marketing director, which is a new role that is available within feature pack 8. So it is similar to a marketing manager role. All the access privileges apply as in the case of a marketing manager. But in addition, a marketing director can download now exported information of customer segments. Customer segments are set of specific users matching a certain criteria. So when such information are exported, this information is available for download to a marketing director of the organization. enhancements on the catalog tool. It is predominantly on the area of rule-based sales category creation, where the WebSphere Commerce search utilities are deployed. So a business user basically finds all the catalog entries of products based on conditions that he configures to add to rule-based sales categories. And also, in case of viewing specific products which match an attribute condition of an attribute dictionary, that is also possible in a catalog tool from this feature pack 8 release. In the promotions tool, the enhancements are in the space of finding promotions matching the search criteria using the WebSphere feature. Also, a business user can now archive active promotions so that those promotions do not appear in the list of all the promotions on successful login of the business user. So those are archived promotions displayed on the list. In marketing tool enhancements, the enhancements are in the space of exporting customer segment information into CSV files. They can be downloaded. We have seen that as part of a marketing director role. And also configuring marketing activities for specific set of customers who are viewing product information which match certain attributes. Let's say a customer is looking for a specific brand of women dresses. So marketing activities for those customers can now be configured in the marketing tool in this feature pack 8 release. We will see what enhancements are there on the Commerce Composer part of Management Center. We have new optimized widgets for B2B use. There are three new widgets, the SKU list widget, the add to requisition list widget, and predefined dynamic kit list widget that is there in this new feature pack 8 release. So the SKU list widget basically displays all the SKUs associated to a specific product. A snapshot of that is shown towards your right. The other one that you see here is the add to requisition list. So when you see a particular product on the storefront, the quick widget available on this page can add this product that you wish to add to your requisition list, whether it is a private one or a shared one. And also the predefined dynamic kit list widget specifically comes handy where you're dealing with associating a dynamic kit configuration using a configurator like your Sterling configurator. One of the old widget that has been enhanced is the catalog entry list widget so that it can now display all the SKUs associated to a particular product in the product detail page. Because of the enhancements that we see in the widget space, these pages listed here, namely the SKU pages and the predefined dynamic kit pages, are now supported in the Commerce Composer for better layout designing or modeling. We'll see what enhancements are there in the REST framework space. See, IBM basically calls this change as the restification of the Aurora B2B and B2C store models. What has happened here is the Aurora store, including all the site widget JSPs, are now updated to consume REST APIs instead of the traditional BOD services or data beans. So on the storefront JSPs, we have now used the WCF REST tag so as to consume REST APIs based on the need. So the flows that you see here, basically the digital marketing flow or your promotional coupons, the pricing flow, order, basic site navigation or search. All of these are now using REST APIs from this feature pack onwards. So there are major enhancements in the WebSphere Commerce search framework, and also on security framework, like it has enhanced SSL support. There is support for HTTP basic authentication, and also support for whitelist data validation. So these are all dealt at the commerce architectural level in the FEP 8 release. So the entire REST framework, I repeat, has been updated now so that all flows within Aurora Starter Store now use REST APIs. Additionally, all the best practices of working with REST APIs that was found in the earlier releases of Feature Pack have been deployed in Feature Pack 8, so that the creation and the consuming of REST APIs are much simplified in this latest release. We will see the data extract and the data load enhancements. Specifically, I am focusing on the enhancements in the promotions space. So the promotional data within the commerce system can be now extracted into XML format information. So these information are utilized so that you can bulk upload the extracted promotional data into other commerce-based environments, especially when you're dealing with multiple development environments or testing or staging environments. So the XML information can also be imported to systems so that new promotions can be created, or thereby you can also change existing promotion information in such environments. So this is possible now with the latest Feature Pack 8 release. So WebSphere Commerce search specific enhancements. We will see how rule-based sales categories are created. What enhancements are there in contract price indexing and also in the area of search relevancy and auto-suggest enhancements. So in the case of rule-based sales categories, so what happens is search rules are configured on certain products based on either their category, subcategory or product information. Or sometimes based on their attribute values also. I'll explain this by giving you an example. We can create a rule-based sales category for a seasonal sale, say Christmas sale, for a specific brand of women dresses. So search rules that one configures in this scenario would be, we would target the apparel top category with women dresses as the subcategory. Additionally, when you're talking about a seasonal sale of a specific brand, I am going to associate search rules against the manufacturer name, which is the attribute of the product information. And these values would be compared and triggered when a rule-based sales category is to be created. In terms of contract price indexing enhancements, it is basically an architectural change. So where WebSphere Commerce search has built all the calculated prices into the search index. So now B2B storefront, or basically Aurora B2B storefront, can leverage all the indexed price information to support this contract price indexing enhancement on the storefront. In improved search relevancy enhancements, grouping of search results are now happening based on the product information, and when searching for SKUs, it returns product information and also including only available SKUs, as is also part of the search relevancy enhancement. So the most relevant hits of a particular product is now decided based upon the name of the product, the images that are associated to the product, and also the prices that are associated to a product when we want to display all the search results. auto suggest enhancements are seen when displaying the suggested keywords on the storefront. So they are now scoped by the store first and then the catalog. So the products that are appearing in the auto suggest menu, as seen in the one of the snapshots that we have put here, so are driven based on the rule-based filtering that I detailed a bit earlier. So the enablement are done using the management center's store management tool, as highlighted in this snapshot. So as I told you in the example that I gave, this is the step-by-step process that one adopts to create a dynamic sales category. So we can associate a category or attributes or even other properties in the WebSphere Commerce search. So they can be dynamically rendered when a rule-based sales category wants to be created, or it can also be scheduled at a particular point in time. All of this is done using the catalog tool inside the management center. On the faceted navigation of catalog management, the new feature in FEP 8 and specifically on the Aurora B2B storefront, merchandisers can enhance faceted navigation by now adding images to all the facet values. So you see a snapshot of the storefront in an Aurora B2B case. So it has images of headstyle associated to the attribute of headstyle in the product information. So this configuration is again done in the management center's catalog tool. So all product attributes which can have images to better describe them are represented as facet values in the storefront. And this feature you can observe in the product listing pages on the site. On the Sterling CPQ space, the enhancements are in the three enablements that you see on the screen. So the globalization support for this integration is now actually available out of the box with using Visual Modeler in conjunction with Commerce Management Center. So users can basically now use the Visual Modeler to configure dynamic kits or also predefined dynamic kits. And also this works, as I said, along with the Management Center. And end-to-end integration scenarios begins with Commerce Management Center and the use of a configurator, and it proceeds even till the fulfillment through the order. So we can either start with an already pre-configured item which has been done using a configurator, or can manage the configuration during the checkout process and then proceed to order or fulfill. So the feature of configuring predefined dynamic kits are now better supported in the IBM Sterling CPQ integration of the latest feature pack 8 release. On the space of IBM Tea Leaf, there is digital data exchange technology that is available on the storefront to better manage this. Customer experience management, we know any day, is crucial to all types of business, and for this IBM Tea Leaf and IBM Digital Analytics have been the most sought after technical solution. So digital data exchange implementation has been done on the starter store JSP pages, and this implementation captures all the analytical data and relay whatever information it has captured to the analytical provider tools that the storefront integrates with. It can either be IBM Digital Analytics or it can be IBM Tea Leaf. So in the Tea Leaf space, one important enhancement that we have is using a limited use bundle feature. This actually comes as part of testing Tea Leaf's capability in the test environment using Commerce with Tea Leaf together. So these three features that you see are what we get by using a tea leaf alongside with the newer feature pack leaves of commerce. So one can identify and resolve applications that are very hard, and this is the efficiently and in a fast manner. Customer interaction points on the problem as options for the business. It is to use as tea leaf. I wish to summarize, giving you a brief overview of our Royal Cyber. With 600 plus professionals, and also being an IBM Premier Business Partner for 10 plus years, Royal Cyber has delivered a lot of work in the smarter commerce space. It has been the recipient of several prestigious awards, like the Mobile Innovation Award for the year 2013 and the Enterprise Modernization Award for 2014. One of our clients, Office Brands, is also the winner of Smarter Commerce Cell Award for the year 2013. So we also do digitization of the B2B channel, where our team works efficiently. We possess the Smarter Commerce authorization, and Royal Cyber specifically offers both hosted and SaaS-based solutions for larger and mid-market organizations. Yeah, I wish to open up. I think we have another 5 minutes to open up for Q&A. You may also post your queries for us at commerce.marketing@royalcyber.com.